imagine I'm pushing my hip, the right side forward, and then I push the left side forward. Take my concentration to the right side of my hip, push forward, left side of the hip, push forward. If you notice, my shoulders are staying in position as I do that. So I'm not twisting the whole body this way, it's just the hip, I just want to isolate that. I'm not turning so far that my knees come out of alignment and I end up hurting my back. So I'm stopping the movement with a little bit of tension right here in my abdomen. So next is, instead of pushing, I'm gonna imagine pulling. So I take the hip and I pull, pull, pull. So before I was pushing, and now I'm concentrating on the pull. So the front hip, pull, pull. Those two together, so I'm going to, at the same time as I pull, I'm also going to push, so I'm just imagining pulling and pushing together. As I put one foot forward, I'll bring my hands onto my side, and instead of turning the waist and the shoulders stay still, everything moves together. The hip and shoulder is moving together, but my head is staying in the middle. You know, I'm not rotating so far that I spin off center. My spine is the axis. Same thing I can imagine pushing from the back, pushing, 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 pushing this way. Or pulling, or just both. Make sure I do that on both sides. It's a large movement. Torso and waist and hip are all moving together. Incorporate that circular rotational movement into a thrusting straight motion. Extend one hand, pull with that hand, and turn. See the way my waist, my shoulders are moving together. I'm not one, two, or one, two, it's together. One. Pulling. Hips and shoulders together. Right, back leg straightening slightly. So I'm using the push of the leg as well as the turning of the waist. Momentary point of focus here, tightening and then release. Release. So now I'm using the balls of my feet to turn. Bring my whole body to move together.